Now, I want to talk about, in the United States, what are the most common causes that a patient will develop cirrhosis? Well, the most common causes in the United States are chronic hepatitis B, hepatitis C, and alcohol-induced liver disease. So this is excessive drinking of liver. So you might just want to write yourself a note on the side there. You would say alcohol and hepatitis. So make sure you write that in the margin so that will stand out in your mind. Now, any chronic liver disease, including non-alcoholic fatty liver disease, can cause cirrhosis. So we want to make sure that you've got that clear. But our most common causes are hepatitis and excessive alcohol. Now, there's three main categories of risk factors for cirrhosis that I want you to keep in mind. Now, this relates to the United States. The first one is excessive alcohol. If the patient has an excessive alcohol problem, then they're really increasing the risk for cirrhosis. So there's a lifestyle factor that we need to intervene to help them understand the importance of liver health and limiting their alcohol. The next one in the United States is excessive weight. Now, excessive weight puts the patient at risk for non-alcoholic fatty liver disease, and that can turn into cirrhosis. Another common factor is viral hepatitis. Now, not everyone with chronic hepatitis will develop cirrhosis, but it is one of the world's leading causes of liver disease. So you're going to be looking at three of these major categories: excessive alcohol, excessive weight that leads to fatty liver disease, we're talking about non-alcoholic fatty liver disease, or if the patient has chronic hepatitis. So if I have a patient who's had chronic hepatitis, is extremely overweight, and drinks excessive alcohol, that's a recipe for disaster. So you're going to have to be very gentle and careful as you approach patient education with a patient with all three of the risk factors.